Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this new webinar from GeoMax. I am Alberto Caligaris, and in the next 40 minutes, 1 hour, we will see together an introduction on what is XPAD 365. So we organized this webinar since probably most of you updated the XPAD software in the last weeks, and probably most of you have seen that now, since the latest release, we require to register with a free license with XPAD 365 to assess the possibility to download the XPAD updates. But what I want to show you in this webinar is that so it is necessary, it's true, to register a free account to XPAD 365 to download the updates, but also what are the other benefits that we have with an XPAD 365 registration. Because you will see together with me that there are a lot of benefits to have now an account with XPAD 365. So this is the agenda for this webinar. So a very quick introduction, what is XPAD 365, just a couple of slides. Then we will focus more on the features that we have with XPAD 365 basic account. That is the free account that you can register from the tablet or from our web interface. And then what are the resources and the features of this basic account, and then we also will see what are the features of the paid account, what we call Pro and Enterprise. Well, first of all, what is XPAD 365? So XPAD 365 is a cloud platform. So it's a cloud platform that links all our XPAD suite, so XPAD Ultimate on the controller, XPAD Fusion on the PC, but also the hardware, that offer a connection and integration between the different software, the field and office application, and it is accessible because it's a cloud platform anytime from anywhere. It's a platform that we are building, so now we already have a lot of features included in XPAD 365, but it's a platform that will grow a lot in the next years. What we are offering now in the XPAD 365 platform, so what are the features that we have, and we will see better during this webinar. For example, there is the possibility to have a cloud data storage and file exchange, connection between field to office, field to field, registration of asset, video tutorial on XPAD, collaborative survey, backup. So there are a lot of features that we are offering in the basic account or in the, what we call Pro or Enterprise account. And of course, it's also something that we will increase in the next years. Okay, let's start with a basic account. So as I said at the beginning, probably most of you have seen that, since the last update, we require to register an XPAD 365 account in order to continue to receive the normal XPAD updates that we always deliver every 2-3 months. But okay, what is this basic account and what we can do with this basic account? So this is the page that probably you have seen during the registration. So let me also show you here on my tablet. So if you have downloaded the latest XPAD update on the login, now let me open just a job, on the login you see this message. So this message suggests you to create a free account, a basic account, to have the possibility to continue to get the Xpad updates that we always provide for free, but also to access other features. Then now I will show you. So when you see this message at the end, what we can do? Of course, if we already have an account with Xpad 365, we can log in with our username or password, or we just click on register now and we just enter our information, so name, surname, country, who is our dealer, email address, and then we can register. So there are two possibilities to register to create an Xpad 365 account. So we can create it directly from here, from the tablet. Otherwise, we can also do it from this web page. So x-pad365.geomax-positioning.com. We can also do it from this page here. And again, here we have the possibility to click try now. And here we can create the basic account. There is also so you see, again, we can enter our basic information and then we will receive an email with the login. And then the account is created. Registering the account, also, there is another possibility. So when I try to create the account, you see that I have this one 6 months trial period. What does it mean? This is only if I try to create the account from the PC, because if I try to create the account from the tablet, it's automatically is automatically defined if you have the trial or not. What is this trial period? So if you have an active Xpad license, so it means that you have a subscription with Xpad to get our 2 or 3 yearly updates with new features. This means that you have the possibility to use the Pro license, so not the basic, but the Pro also with the backup, with the cloud, so with some additional services for free for 6 months. And then, of course, after 6 months, it's up to you to continue to use the service, or you can automatically account is converted to the basic account. So here you just enter your Xpad Ekimen ID, Xpad serial number, and if our system verify that you have a valid Xpad license, your account will not be a basic, but will be a pro license for 6 months. There is this option only on the web, because if you do this operation on the tablet, so if you register from here, we already know your license information. Okay, so this is the Ekimen ID and the serial, so you can see from this page. So from the tablet, we already know this information. So it's automatically verified. So during the registration from the tablet, if we verify that you have a valid service pack, using my case, for example, it's valid until 3 November of this year, this means that I am creating not a basic account, a free account, but I will have the pro version for 6 months, and then automatically it will be converted to the basic if I don't renew it. Okay? So here we can register our account. Okay? And again, I would like to remember it that is completely free. So you have seen this message, probably you have registered, okay, to create the free account. And then after the registration, what we can do. Now let's start to have a demonstration at the end of what we can do with the free account. So let me again share here the controller. So now I already created the account, so I can register. Sorry, I can log in. Okay. So I already created a basic account. So you see now I can see my license. Okay, so license is a free license, and this is my data. So I can also activate if I want the automatic login. So what I can do now? Here, sorry, we have this icon here on the top right. You see is the Xpad 365 icon, and you see now I am connected, okay, because here it's green. We can click here. So here we see the information from Xpad 365. Here in the second page, we see the services. So this is a free account. So of course, I don't have the backup and restore, the collaborative survey. This we do not have. We will see this function later with the Pro account. What I can do, first of all, I can register my asset. So you see here I have the possibility to register the software and the hardware. So the software is automatically registered. So now because I created the account from the tablet. So you see my Xpad software is automatically registered. So in my Xpad 365 account, I registered my license. Then I have also the possibility to register the hardware. So what is this list? This list is the list of the hardware that Xpad is finding in my settings. So these instruments are the instruments that I have here. Okay, so I have a lot because this is my support tablet, so I have a lot of different instruments. You see, Xpad automatically recognizes what are the instruments that you have in your tablet, and then you have a very quick way to register. So, for example, if I want to register my Zenith 40, here I can enter the article number and the key and or the serial. So here I can also check where I can find this information, and I can register the device. So for example, let's register. So this is the material number, this is the serial number. So I can find this information on the instrument. If it is correct. Sorry, this is wrong. This should be correct. Okay, you see, I registered the device. Okay, now I have registered the software and the hardware. So what is the benefit to have now this device registered? Let's see here on the PC. Okay, so now I log in. I log in with the same account on the web interface. Okay, so this is the web interface for the same account that we have seen on the PC. Here I can go in the asset manager. So also here from the asset manager, I have the possibility to register the data. But here I can, what is the benefit? Here I can access my resources. So, for example, I register the hardware, so I can go in device. Of course, I have also the possibility from here to register new devices. So, you see, this is my Zenith 40 that I just registered from the tablet. Here I can see, okay, I can see some information, but what is important, here I have the resources. So, for example, I can download. I don't know, the Zenith Manager, the tools, so the software. I can, you see, the tools for my GPS. I can download the guides. I can, for example, download a webinar that is related to GNSS. Let's see, for example, what I have for the software. So for the software here, I registered Ultimate, so I double-click. This is Ultimate page. Again, here I have some information, and here in the resources, you see I have really a lot of different resources related. So, for example, I have the setup file, I have the release notes, I have the brochure if I need, I have a lot of PDF and video tutorial. So, for example, I need to know how to start a GNSS base. You see, here I have the video tutorial. I can download or directly open the link. Okay, so you see, I have a lot of here. You see, I have the video tutorial that explain me how to start the GNSS base. So we have created for the 365. You see, we have created really a lot of different video tutorial and guide. So you see, we have really like 106 video tutorial and guide available. So you see, there are some PDF, there are some video. So this is related for all devices, hardware and software that you can register in Expand 365. So it's really, I think, an important resources that is available if you register to Expand 365, because also because before this information was not available. So what you can register? You can register the software, you can register the hardware, or you can also register your subscription that you have with GeoMax. Okay, so here we have seen how you can register your hardware and your software. So you can do it from the tablet or you can do it from the web interface, and then after you have registered your asset, you can open the related resources. So you see, for example, this is the resources for Expand and this is the resources for the Zenith 40, but it's also the same for other hardware. So if you register at Zoom 90, you will have the guides and all the material we prepared for the Zoom 90. So that's I think it's a very, very important features to have. In addition to the resources connected to a single device, also we have what we call it Virtual Training Academy. So we have another basket of resources that instead are also available on the web interface or on the tablet. So let me show you how you can open this material. So here from the web interface, you just click on this link, Virtual Training Academy, and here also you can find PDF guides, you can find video tutorial on Ultimate, you can find the video tutorial for Fusion, you can find the webinar, for example. So you see also here we have 132 resources available, so video, I don't know, like for example, let me search, so I need to do something with surface and volume. So here I can click it. Here you see I have different for Fusion or for Ultimate. So for example, how can I take out a surface with Expand Ultimate? And here I have the video. I have the video tutorial that explains me how I can take out a surface with Ultimate. Or for example, I want to see the webinar, because this is also where we will upload this webinar that we are doing now. So here I can also select webinar as tags, and here we can find, you see, the latest webinar that we already uploaded, and the next webinar, all the next webinar will be uploaded in this page. We can also access this material. So this is from the web interface, but what happens if I need to see this information in the field? Also here from the Expand 365 page on the tablet, I have technical resources. And here also you see I have several video tutorials. So for example, I don't know how to use the GIS features. I can directly open the video tutorial from the tablet. So this, as you can imagine, if I am in the field, is good, because if I don't remember how to use a function and the video tutorial is available, I can directly see the video tutorial directly on the tablet. And this is something that was not available before, and you can only use it now because you have Expand, a basic account in the Expand 365. Okay? Another features that we have with the XPA365 in the basic account is also notification and the news. So if you register, for example, like I did, I registered at Zenith 40 and I registered Ultimate Software. In case there is any update, for example, there is a new version of Ultimate, I will receive an email that a new version is available, what is included in the new version, and so on. So that's also a good way to be updated on what are the new features of the instruments that you have. Okay, so let's continue with the presentation now. So just to resume, we have seen how to register a free account on the XPA365 and why now we decided to have this option to register an account, how you can register your asset, so software and hardware. And then after you have an account, how you can access the resources of the software and hardware you registered, and how to view the Virtual Training Academy video tutorial, PDF guide, webinar, and so on that we created. So this is what you can do with the free account. So as you can see, as a XPAD user, there are really a lot of benefit, in particular because there is really a lot of material guides that will help you, and they are already available online, and more material will come in the next weeks. Now, just also few slides about the Pro and Enterprise account. So this is what so we have seen what you can do with the free account, but then also we have other two accounts that we call it Pro and Enterprise. So Pro and Enterprise, there are not free account, there is a yearly subscription, but you have some additional features in the Pro and in the Enterprise account. As we said in the beginning, if you register an account with a valid expert, automatically also you have the pro account. So you have the possibility to test the pro account for 6 months. So if you have a valid expert, you can check it and probably you have a pro account already. So what are the additional features that we have in the in Pro account? So first of all, we have the data storage. So depends also, we have different options on how many gigabytes you have, but what we offer is a cloud data storage where you can share your data, you can upload in real time the data from the field to the office and the office to the field. You can make this data available to a coworker in real time, and also you can link external cloud server. So let me show you a quick demo about the data storage. Now let me log out from my basic account and I log in with my Pro account. Okay, so this is my account. You see that here I have some additional icons compared to the basic one. In particular, here you can see a storage. So in my account, I have more or less 1 gigabyte of data. And here I have the file manager. So this is the file manager that I have from the PC, from the web interface. So here I have. You see, I have the data that I shared, so XPAD file, DXF, ASCII file, so material that I want to share from office to the field. Of course, I have also the possibility to create folder. I can also, for example, for a folder or for a file, I can manage access. So if I have an account with more sub-users, I can also define, okay, some sub-users have the possibility to access this folder, some other users not. And then when I have the file, of course, I can share the file, I can download the file, create the link, and so on. And another possibility is also to link existing Dropbox, Google Drive, or OneDrive account. Similar interface I have also on the tablet. Let me just connect my other tablet with the Pro account. Okay. So in this case, I am logged in with another account with an enterprise license in this case. So now that I have also the data storage, what I can do, for example, let me open, okay, let's open, for example, this job. Okay, now when I export the data, so let's say, okay, I want to export the DXF data of my project. And I export the data, you see, I can immediately save the data on the XPAD 365 storage area. So let's call it, for example, webinar XF. Okay, you see these are the same folder we have seen. Okay, let's store it, for example, here in project data. Okay, so the data is immediately created on the cloud platform and now is available from the office. The same is also for the import. Let's say, okay, let's create a new job, for example. Let's say, okay, I want to import data a DXF file. Here I can click on cloud and directly download the data from the cloud. Okay, so these are my cloud data and immediately I can import. You see, this is the my web interface. And you see, for example, this is the file I have uploaded from the tablet, from the field to the office. So the data is immediately available in the office and I can easily download the file. So very, very quick operation that I can do. So this is a data storage that is available with the Pro and with the Enterprise account. Sorry. Another function that is available in the Pro and in the Enterprise account is the data backup. So with the Pro and Enterprise, it is possible to create data backup to that are created on the cloud server. So I can create local, sorry, and also on the cloud server, I can create a backup of my jobs, of my settings. So in case, for example, the tablet is broken, is stolen, so something happened to my controller, all my settings, so I don't know, code list, jobs, instrument profile, all the data is not lost. Let me show you here the option on the tablet. So again, we open the XPAD 365 page. Now you see here that we have backup and restore. So here we have the possibility to create a local backup. So local backup means that I just create a backup of all my, so I can choose it because I can just create a backup for the application, for the site. So site means the jobs. And if I want, I can also upload it to the XPAD 365. So in this case, it will be local, so the backup is stored on the tablet, but of course, in this case, if I lose the tablet, then I also lose the backup, or I can also check up on the to XPAD 365, so XPAD will create a backup, and then it also will upload the backup to the cloud, so in case the tablet is lost, I have to say all the data is stored on the cloud. So I can create, you see, local backup, I can create a backup synchronized with the, so sorry, uploaded on the cloud, or I can create an automatic backup. So automatic backup, you see, I have to start the service, is an interesting solution because it keeps the data synchronized between the office and the field. Sorry, it's more correct to say from the cloud to the field. So as soon as I have a new job, a new file, something that is changed on the tablet, XPAD 365 keeps the data also copied on the cloud. So, because of course, if I do this kind of backup, I do it today. But what I will do tomorrow is not automatically saved. In this case, with the automatic yes. So it's a way to always keep my backup synchronized with what I have on the field. And then, of course, if unfortunately something happened to the tablet, here I have, you see, the possibility to restore my data. So you know that we have the possibility to move the license between different tablets. So you move the license from the stolen or broken tablet, and then using these tools, you can easily restore your data. So the data is not lost. Another function that we have is the chat and data share. This is in particular is interesting in the enterprise account because the difference between the pro and the enterprise account is that in the pro, I am a single user. In the enterprise account, I am a user with sub-users, with co-workers is more correctly to say. So I have a certain number of co-workers that I have inside the account. And then I have this chat where that I can use to send messages, but I can also use it to share the file. So it's quite useful if I'm working in a team of surveyors because I have the, you see here I have the chat that I can use to I can use it to, for example, you see, send a message, but I can also use it to share a file. But it's very well integrated in XPath because, for example, if I create a site calibration, then I can easily share in the chat. Okay, so you see, I can create a site calibration and I can share the chat with a colleague. I can share a code list, I can share a different type of data. So it's not just a WhatsApp replacement, let's say, but it's really something integrated with the surveying software that allow me also to share the cartographic system, job that I am exporting, a code list, and so on. Collaborative survey, that is a very interesting solution in the XPath 365 Pro and Enterprise. It allow to work together on the same project using different controllers. So we already did different webinar on this topic with live. So if you are interested to see more on the collaborative survey, you can log in the XPath 365 and search for this webinar, okay? So open here our Virtual Training Academy. So you can open our Virtual Training Academy. In this case, we can search for XPath 365 and this webinar here, XPath 365 Six Keys to Enhancing Your End Workflow, we have a live demonstration of the collaborative survey. At the end, just to simplify, what is the collaborative survey? We can have two or more surveyors working at the same time on the same job, measuring point or staking out point at the same time, and the data is synchronized between the different tablets. So all the tablet working in the same collaborative survey will see in real time the points measured by the other crew members and the same for the stakeout of point. But again, if you want to see more, I suggest you to have a look at this webinar where we had here with Francesca Andrea, we did a live demonstration of this solution. Last function that I want to show you is something that is only related to the enterprise account. So because the difference between the pro and the enterprise is that in the enterprise, we have the possibility to manage more users. So we can create sub account for coworkers. And then with this coworker, for example, we can interact with the chat. We can, of course, here create more account. We can, for example, define different access to the folders that we have in the storage area and also something more. Okay, so this concludes our presentation on Xpad 365. If you have any question, you can write the question directly here in the GoToWebinar panel. In the meantime, I also want to remember you that we will upload this webinar here on the Virtual Training Academy of Xpad 365. So after tomorrow, probably it will be already here. So you can again log in the Xpad 365. Here you can search the webinar, or you just select the tag webinar, and here you will find the webinar, okay, that we have done today. Okay, here I see a question. If I can show you again how to access the resources of the registered asset. So let me show you quickly again. So after you create the account, you have the possibility to register your software and your hardware. How you can register your software and your hardware? You can do it directly from the tablet. So you open the Xpad 365 page. Then you go here in Asset, and you see you can register the different instruments that you have. Okay, so this page automatically, in this page, you have the list of your instruments that are available in the settings of Xpad. So if you want, for example, to register it here, you have a Zoom 50. You see, you need to enter the article number, the serial number. So here, if you are not sure, you can check here the guide where you can find this information, and you can register your device. Okay, so you can register your hardware and your software, but if you create the account from the tablet, the software is automatically registered. So you can do it from the tablet, or you can do it from web interface. So also from the web interface, you have the possibility. The procedure is exactly the same. So here you have the possibility to, you click here on new, and you see you can again, here you have the guides, and you have the possibility here to register the device. After you have registered your device, for example, here, let me open, you see, I registered a Zenith 35 Pro. I just double click, and then I click here on resources, and this is where I can find the resources of my device. So here, for example, these are the resources for the 35 Pro. Let's go, for example, in the software. Ah, okay, I have not registered here because probably this was registered. Let me try. Otherwise, I will log in with the other one. If it is not already registered. Okay, let's see. Okay, so I let me log in because this is my, we have several accounts, so probably I already registered the device with another account. So let me log in with this one. Probably I already registered the license with another account. Okay, so here you see I have the software registered. So also for the software, you see I can click on resources, and here I can find all the available resources, in this case for Xpad, so the video tutorial and other material. If for any reason, for example, this is also something nice to show you. If for any reason, for example, I want to download an old version of Xpad, Here I can also change it. You see, for example, for any reason I want to downgrade my version, I can select the diff. So this is the latest version that we have. For example, I can also download an old version for 6.13. Here I can download the file. You see, this is the installation file of the version 4.6.30. And now you see if I change, this is the latest release. And this is, you see, is the latest release. So it's also interesting because here you have also the possibility, for example, to download the release or to see the release notes, but also to download the previous version of the software in case. Okay, I don't see any other question, so I would like to thank you for the participation to this webinar. Again, I will upload the registration of the webinar to the XPAD 365 Virtual Trading Academy. And of course, if you have any other question, everything, just contact us on our email address. Thank you very much for your participation, and I hope to see you again in the next webinar.